Monday solar eclipse will be an event you do not want to miss. It's the perfect time to come together, get your kids and yourself excited about science.
Yeah, you could talk all day about how pumped up we are for this celestial event. We're going to be anchoring a special coverage starting at noon from Indianapolis. But for some insight on just how cool this will be, let's turn to our next guest, who you know. He is the CEO of the Planetary Society. You know him likely as Bill Nye, the science guy. All right, Bill, to those who say they don't have the time, maybe they're thinking of skipping this phenomenon, you have a message. What do you say?
Don't skip it. And yes, you have the time. First of all, if you're in the path of totality and you're in Indianapolis, you're talking about 3 minutes. You could probably squeeze that in. But it goes on for some time before and after that. You watch the moon come in front of the sun. And what makes it spectacular is it's a total eclipse. You know, in October we had an annular eclipse. Annular is Latin for ring. There was a ring of light around the moon because the moon's orbit isn't quite round. It's a little bit elliptical. And so this time the moon will be close enough to Indianapolis to make it completely dark. Even if it's cloudy, it will be completely dark and it will turn to night like that.
So we understand you're going to be watching from Texas, where there will be totality. We also know that there are going to be rockets and all kinds of science experiments unfolding as the eclipse is happening. What would you say are the biggest science lessons we can learn from a total eclipse?
Well, the biggest science lesson for me is the extraordinary accuracy with which astronomers are able to predict these events and where it's going to get dark and where it's going to be in a shadow and not quite dark and so on. It's remarkable. You know, if you had a psychic or a tarot card reader or somebody who could make predictions with this kind of accuracy, I would presume that she or he would be rich, but that is not the case. But astronomers understand the movement of the Earth and Sun with such precision that we can determine the path of totality within a hundredth of a second. Recently, that was decided that some of the calculations on the diameter of the sun were off a little bit. And so if you're on the very edge of the path of totality, be sure to get all the way in. Be sure to get all the way in. If those calculations, if the map you're looking at turns out to be off by a couple thousand feet, then, you know, that's how accurately they can determine it. You know, between you and a freeway exit, they can determine how dark it's going to be. It's really something.
Yeah, no, it's amazing. And what do you think people should be? You tell me. I mean, maybe as they're going into this experience, should they have something in mind? Or do you think they should just go in without any sort of expectation? Is it more a spiritual experience? Is it a scientific experience? How can they go forward with it?
So for many of us, a science experience and a spiritual experience are closely related, that humans can understand the motion of these objects and see this remarkable effect is fantastic. But I will say two things to everybody about this. First of all, getting into totality is worth it. If you have to drive an hour or two, you know, most of us live in the Eastern time zone, and so this will go right through the Eastern time zone. If you can get in the path to totality, it's worth it. The other thing, human nature being what it is, we just want to stare at the sun. Even if it's cloudy, you just want to stare up there. So be sure to have these glasses. Now, these are eclipse glasses. You can look straight at the sun with them, even though they're paper and mylar plastic. They are about 100,000 times darker than sunglasses. Sunglasses will not do it. That is not the thing. You got to have the real deal. These are available from our website at planetary.org. Of course, everyone watching is a member. Of course you all are at planetary.org/eclipse. And also, I was in a hardware store yesterday and they were selling them in a hardware store. Yes.
Smart. So
we have ours.
We do. We've got ours. ISO compliant, I hope. quickly, Bill, I saw you did a cover for Time Out Magazine.
International Standards Organization. Yeah.
Yeah, I saw you did the cover of Time Out Magazine. I had asked for these pictures to get put on, but apparently it would cost CNN like thousands of dollars, and we could get sued if we don't pay the photographer who took them, so we don't want to get in trouble. But these are some pictures, man. You look outstanding. And I know last time we had you on, we talked about doing a calendar. I'm wondering, if I get the pieces in place, what kind of cut would you give Brianna and I to put out a Bill Nye calendar with steamy images like the ones you did for Time Out Magazine?
I don't know. Sure. I don't want to promise you royalties, but I'm sure with the success of my calendar, your careers, you know, all the tide raises all ships. Am I right, people?
It does.
So yeah, we'll work on that calendar. Everybody, it was fun. Time Out contacted me about doing these things, and they show up with these extraordinary outfits, what the young people call streetwear.
Yeah.
And I got into it. You know, I had a chip on my shoulder. I got an attitude about people who are not into science. I got a problem with them. Because I'll give, you know, do you want a problem?
No,
because I'll
no,
give
sir.
You a problem, all right?
No, sir. Absolutely
like
not.
It was like that. I'm kidding,
no,
everyone.
Sir. Nobody
kidding,
should mess with Bill Nye.
But it was fun. And don't miss the eclipse on Monday. It's the next one's not for 20 and a half years
a
or
time.
So. Yeah. And I hope to be here for that one, but there's no guarantee. And it's just a fantastic event. You'll hear, it'll be night, birds will chirp, crickets will crick, and generally there's a little bit of a breeze created by the cool air next to the warm air, and it's fantastic.
Amazing. It's going to be great, Bill, and we cannot wait to experience it and check in with you after. And we thank you for your time today. Thank you so, so much. We are out of time, unfortunately. We're going to be right back.
Thank you. Here we are. Thank you, Boris.